Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. So in today's video we are going to be looking at the behind the scenes of this beautiful kente gown. This is the bride rocking her kente gown and I hope you enjoy this. Kisses! This is me making sketches of the whole process. Okay, so this is me getting the sketch of how the kente should look like at the end of the day. I'm really trying my best not to use the word actually. That is why I'm having these pauses, so please excuse me for that and pardon me for that. So I made these sketches of how it would actually look like, sorry. So this is basically how the sketch came out to be. And this is what I sent her, she liked it, and that was it. I started from there. I started working on the slit and how every pattern had to be present and how every detail had to be appreciated. So I started with it on the brown paper. Here, brown papers are super extra accessible than the other forms of pattern paper, so this is basically me using the brown paper to get the effect that I wanted. And that side is actually me getting to work on the tail, so this is how the tail would be like. So that's why I did add that extension to do that cutting, and then I moved to the main kente to do all the cutting that was expected of me to do. I do make sure I do all these sketches on these brown papers and do the cuttings on brown papers because it makes the work super extremely easy. Okay, there is no waste of fabric, no waste of kente, no waste of anything. Okay, so I do appreciate that section, and I do what I went ahead and went to work at the bodice. So basically this one is how the bodice is expected to look like at the end of the day. So this is basically the sketching, just, and this is the back of the sketch. Sorry, the camera wasn't positioned well, so you basically cannot see it well. I did do some stiffing, and this is the final look for the bodice. Yes, this is how the whole bodice actually looked like. Okay, so I hope you're enjoying this video. If you're really enjoying this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and share with your family and friends to help our channel and community grow and make more impact in our lives. So this is actually the end of the slit. This is the slit. This is how the slit looked like with the slants, those details, those beaders from the sequins. Like, this is how it actually looked like. This is the final look of the slit. So I hope you're enjoying this video. Okay, so with this, the kente was actually purchased from Adepa Kente on Instagram. I will be leaving her link in the description, so you can just check out some of the patterns and unique designs she has. So with this section, sorry about my flap, I was basically wrapping up to go to work, and I had to send pictures and then do a bit of video in for this episode. Okay, so here this main blaze in the back to actually give it the effect that is expected to get when she wears it. So I brought everything to the mannequin and made sure that I presented all the cards and everything that is expected to be with her. Okay, she didn't want to be exposing her back that much. Okay, and I wanted to cover up for her as well, so I did a card to be added to the kente so that she wouldn't be exposing. No. So this is the end product of this laser. This is actually how the laser looked like, and this is how the gown came out looking like with all the details, with all these sequins and seed beads. Okay, this is actually how it came out to look like. Okay, so this was the final look. I hope you're enjoying this video. Don't forget to give it a thumbs up and also share with your friends and family. I didn't actually sketch or sew that part so that it would, I wanted to finish with everything before I sew it, attach it to the dress, and then send it to her. She was in our capital in a car. She was in a car in Kumasi, so she was basically in our capital. So I had to send it through DHL to get it to her. I think I used VIP rather. She was very closer to VIP, so I used VIP to send it to her. And this was the final pictures I took before sending it to Gifty. Thank you so much, Gifty, for trusting me with this piece. I super am extremely appreciative of that. Thank you. This is the final look. What should you say about this dress? Please drop your comments below. I really need these comments. Do you drop your comments below and let me see what you also think about this Gifty gown, because I think it's fine. I think it's beautiful. I think I'm really did the best I could. I think this is perfect. I really do believe this is perfect. The beading, the detailing, everything was on point. The corset detailing, everything is on point. Okay, so what do you also think about this piece? Yes, comment below. I will be waiting for your comments. So this was the final look, and this is the final picture that I sent her. And also, this is how Adipa Kente comes in. It comes in different colors, different shades, and different patterns. So link up below in the description and get contact with her. This is also the bride in the gown. This is the final look. These are some videos she sent me. This is a video she took with her phone that she sent me to thank me for how I made her beautiful. And thank you, Gifty, for also trusting me with your piece. This is how she looked at the end of the day. I can't wait to get a professional pictures of them so that I can actually post them on my Instagram and TikTok. I just can't wait. And these are some of the compliments that I had from the bride herself and some friends in my contact list. Thank you so very much for supporting me and watching it till this far. I really am appreciated of this love. Okay, I really appreciate this love and support. Thank you so very much. If you've made it this far, kisses and SOSO. I will be leaving all my information in my description. So let's just link up on our other socials and get to know each other. I'm down for that, okay? So have a lovely weekend. XO.